Hi there, it's me again. So I wanted to tell you a little bit more about my why. Why did a doctor become a coach? Why did I become a coach? So it takes you, let me take you a little bit back to a couple years ago. So back in 2013, I was overweight, I was stressed out, I was working days, evenings, overnights, and I was just feeling really, really run down. And you see, I'm someone that I've always worked out. To me, working out is a stress reliever. To me, it is my natural antidepressant is what I call it. And I always worked out. My biggest problem was always my nutrition. And I was an overweight child. You know, I was overweight in high school. I was overweight in college. I gained 30 pounds in college. And you know, I did get in better shape in medical school, but then when residency came around, that weight started to come back on. And so because I wear scrubs all the time and because, you know, I was always, you know, just really stressed out, my body started to pack on the pounds again. And next thing I knew, a lot of my clothes didn't fit me. And so I needed something that I could do at home that was quick and effective. And so at the time, I had come across T25 minutes. I had told myself, if I could do 25 minutes, you know, I can do 25 minutes. I can give myself that time. I can make that time for myself. And at the time, when I came across that program, somebody had said, you should try Shakeology. And I said, you know what? Why not? What do I have to lose? I don't have anything to lose. And so they had talked to me about the coaching opportunity, actually, because they told me I could get 25% off. And so me, I was like, great, let me try it for at least a couple months. If I like it, I'll continue buying more, and I definitely want the discount. And so I actually signed up really as what we call a discount coach. I was really kind of just looking for a solution for my problem, which was that none of my clothes were fitting me. And so I started, and immediately I jumped right into, I immediately saw the opportunity, and I was like, you know what? What if I can help one person? What if I can help two people? And even, you know, what if I share my story and I share my journey? I'm a busy person. What if I share my journey and I inspire someone else? So I started posting on social media and I started showing that I was excited about my program. I started showing results. But even before I started showing results, I just started really just sharing my struggles, sharing that I was only working out 25 minutes, but I was getting a good sweat on. And people started to come to me and they started to, you know, kind of just give me acknowledgments that they saw what I was doing and they wanted more information. And that's kind of how I got into my coaching. And it's interesting because around the time when I got into my coaching, I remember in my emergency room, there had been a lot of young girls coming in, really depressed, wanting to commit suicide, and I wanted to sit down with them and counsel them, and they were overweight. And I know that them being overweight and having low self-esteem was a huge factor in their depression. And so I wanted to sit down with them and help them, and I could not. I could not do that because I didn't have time in the emergency room. So when this opportunity came and kind of fell into my lap, I realized that this was my way to give back and my way to pour into others and my way to really help someone feel better about themselves from the inside out. And so for me, now that I've been doing this for over 2.5 years, I know why this came into my life. And I have 3 missions as a coach. Number one, it's really to empower women and to help them feel beautiful in the skin that they're in. I know that when you love who you see in the mirror, when you feel confident, when you feel beautiful, that's only gonna help you in every other aspect of your life. It'll help you, you know, as a spouse, as a mom, as an employee. That confidence is going to take you so many places. And so for me, number one, that's a huge passion of mine, is empowering women. Number two is preventing disease. Absolutely, you know, and I know that what you put in your body today, how you treat your body today, will come back to either help you or hurt you many years down the road. And so because I'm an ER doctor, I tend to see all the accumulation of poor habits over the course of years in my ER. And so for me, I want to prevent those things. And I know that through diet, nutrition, and also helping people with their mindset and keeping their mind healthy will help them prevent diseases later on in the future. And then my third is truly the entrepreneur aspect of this. Being able to help other young families, other women, other men become financially secure in their life. You know, this business can take you anywhere. It can, you can grow so much. And so for me, I saw a lot of opportunity in that, and I actually got really excited because, you know, when I had graduated medical school, I felt like there was still something that was missing. Yes, it's a very big accomplishment to go through medical school, to go through residency, but I still felt like something was missing, like I had not found my passion. And it wasn't until I found this opportunity, the fact that I know I will be giving back so much, the fact that I know I will be continuing to grow myself, you know, more and more over the next couple years, that challenge actually excites me and actually makes me look forward to what is to come in the future. And so that's my why I decided to stick with this, why I am absolutely in love with this opportunity. And I hope that this inspires you to come on board and to be a part of our mission. Thank you. Bye.